Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We just lost a very dear brother of ours, Kota Kanj. You know, I was with him two nights ago. We had performed Umrah in Mecca, and then he left for Medina, spent the day in Medina, prayed the Dhuhr prayer in the Rawda, directly behind the Imam, spent 2 hours in the Rawda, in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then towards the end of the day, he was feeling some pain, some chest pains, and then when things got really bad, he laid down, surrounded by his family, just at the time of the Maghrib prayer, while the Adhan was being called, he laid there, making Shahada, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered for his life to be taken in Medina, while the Maghrib Adhan was being called, while making Shahada, just after performing Umrah, just after spending 2 hours in the Rawda, to be buried in the Baqi' with the guaranteed intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. What an amazing death. A death that by Allah, I'm green with envy. And the truth is, my brothers and sisters, that his death is not by luck. Because I bear witness and I testified that this brother, he worked so hard for it. He worked so hard, and that he was so sincere that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted him and gave him the honorable death that he has given him. For years, he would pray Fajr in Jama'ah in the masjid, and then he would sit in the same corner until 9 o'clock in the morning, trying to memorize the Quran. And he was struggling. I remember when he would spend a whole week trying to memorize, a whole week, and he would barely get a line. And then from a line, he would get a verse. And then from a verse, he would half a page. Until he reached the point where only less than a year ago, he was so determined to memorize the Quran that he had left him and his family, went to South Africa, enrolled in a full-time hafiz school where he can memorize the Quran, dedicating his time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted him. A few months ago, his mom had passed away. He came back. He was at the service of his mother while she was dying. He slept in the house, didn't leave. Him and all of his siblings and the whole family, they were at the service of their mother until the day that she died, until the day, her last breath, they were there at the service of their mother. You know, my brothers and sisters, if you want a great death, these great deaths, they don't come by chance. No, you have to work for it. You have to work for it, and you got to want it. And you got to be so sincere. And wallahi, if you're sincere and you're dedicated and you work, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept you and give to you like he gave this brother Khadr. Like he gave this brother. I ask you, my brothers and my sisters, how are we spending our days? How are we spending our nights? How will you die? You ask yourself, how will you die? The greatest indication of how you will die is, how did you spend this day that you're watching this video? How did you spend this day? How did you spend last night? This is a very good indication of how you and I will die. Because the way you live, this is the way that you die.